Hello everyone. In this video, we are going to discuss this problem D, divide and sum of the chord forces around 6382. So the problem is that we are given an array of length n, of length 2n, and we are also given what we have to do in this problem is that we have to partition this array into two subsequences p and q of length n, and we have to make sure that each element of the array is exactly in one subsequence. And then what we will going to do is we're going to sort this first subsequence in non-decreasing order and the second subsequence in non-increasing order. And after that, we will call the sorted version as x and y. And then what we have to do is like we have to find a cost of partition, which is fpq, which is sigma I equal to 1 to n xi minus yi, which is the absolute difference of the corresponding elements of the two subsequences that we have divided into. And then we have to find this sum over all the correct partitions of the array. And since this answer can be quite large, so we have to just print the remainder, modulo this quite big prime number. So we have total 10 to the power 1.5 to the power 4 elements of the array. And yeah, so now let us try to understand this problem on the whiteboard. So first of all, this thing is there, that we have this array, initial array is this array having length 2n. So this is a1, a2, all the way to a2n. Let us say we are indexing the array from 1, not from 0. So for sake of understanding. And now let us see like what can be like, and also we need to understand this, that the two partitions can be considered different if the elements on of those two partitions are different at least by one indices, right? So now let us move on. So we need to understand this in this problem. It is, whatever be the way we will partition the array, is this original array, into two subsequences of length n, that is a1, that is we have one subsequence here of length n, and we have another subsequence of length n, which is q subsequence. So like, yeah, of this, they both will have the length n. So whatever be the way we choose the subsequences, the cost of partition of the subsequences p and q will always be constant. And this constant will be what? This constant will be, if we sort this array a1, a2, a2n in non-decreasing order, which is typical sorting, then cost of partition for any partition which will be constant will always be the sum of the last n elements, which is an plus 1. After we sort this array, an plus 1 plus an plus 2 plus an plus 3 all the way to an plus n, which is 2n, minus the sum of the first n elements, right? So I just write it here quickly. So this cost, no matter what the partition you will do, and no matter those partitions are different, like we will always consider different partitions, not the similar one, because for that we have to calculate the sum and the answer of the remainder. So yeah, so no matter what partition you will do, the sum will always be, the cost will always be constant, and this cost will always be given by this constant that I am writing, that is the sum of the first, sum of the last n elements minus the sum of the first n elements. And now we will see the implementation of this, and then after the implementation we will see the proof of this, right? So the implementation is quite easy. What we will gonna do is like this, we will have this array n, and also before implementation, one thing more, like we know that the sum will be constant and sum will be this. So now since the sum is constant, so what we can do is like we have to find the total sum over all such partitions. So total sum over all such partition will be given by sum over one partition into the number sum per partition into the number of partitions, right? sum per partition. I should try this partition quickly. Into number of partitions, and this number of partitions which can I denote like this, number of partitions. And now the number of partitions will be simply the way number of ways to choose n elements from 2n elements. So the number of partition, this will be the number of ways to choose n elements, choose n elements from 2n elements, which is combination of 2n c n, and which is given by, this is given by 2n factorial by n factorial by 2n minus n factorial, which is also n factorial. And this can also be written as, this can also be written like this. We will cancel this n factorial by the first n factorial, and then we will just say simply the multiplication of n plus 1 all the way to 2n divided by the factorial of n, because the first n multiplications, the first n multiplications will be cancelled by this first n factorials. Right, so we will see the implementation now, and then we'll see the proof. If anyone is interested in the proof, they can then, after the implementation, can further continue. So now this is very simple. We have this array, we have sorted this array, and we have calculated the sum of first n elements, and then we will also take the mod, because we don't want, we have to just print the remainder. So then we will calculate the sum of the last n elements, which we call as back sum, and then the answer for one partition will be the sum of back sum minus the front sum, taking the mod with the mod. And now we'll compute their arrangement. And we know to compute factorial of n, what we're going to do is this: we're going to take initially factorial of n equal to 1, and then as we go from from 1 to n, then we will going to multiply this factorial of n with I, and then also take the mod, because we want only the remainder, not the whole value. And then our answer, which is initially this value for one partition, will get also multiplied by n plus 1 to all all the way to n plus n, which is 2n. So like, we are multiplying this, we are you will calculate this first factor, which is this, this is now we are calculating this, and after that we also have to divide by n factorial. And dividing by n factorial is simply means to take the power of n factorial, which is power of n factorial with of mod minus 2. Why mod minus 2? Because of the use of Fermat's little theorem. And the Fermat's little theorem simply says that if you have to calculate Q inverse mod m, then it can be simply said as Q in like A inverse mod m, if A and m are coprime to each other, is A raised to power m minus 2, where m is the value of for which we have to take the mod of. So this is from the Fermat's little theorem. And then we will just simply output our answer, since answer can be negative after doing all these computations. So we can, we'll just simply add mod, and then we'll take the mod again after addition of mod to calculate to output our answer. And now we need to understand why the sum of any partition will always be constant. This CPQ will always be this CPQ. So now we'll do the proof. If anyone is interested in the proof, they can continue. So now we need to understand this, that there will definitely be one partition where we will take the first n elements in one partition and the last n elements in another partition, right? Now we need to show that both these partitions are equivalent, like any partition which is different from this partition is always equivalent to this one. So this is our P partition and this is our Q partition. So we know that we have to sort this P in increasing order and this in decreasing order. So we know that here in corresponding to n, we will have 2n, corresponding to 1, we will have n plus 1, corresponding to 2, we will have n plus 2. So in a similar way, let us take here we will have ai, and here we will have a n plus I. So if we take another partition, which is p dash and q dash, and in p dash and q dash, we can swap two elements from one element from p to from one element of q. If we swap the corresponding elements, like if we swap ai to an plus I, if we swap like this, so then after swapping, ai will be part of q and an plus I will be part of p. And after sorting, all these elements will be, all the elements of p will be like this, a1, a2, all the way to an. We know that we are putting in increasing order, so an plus I will always be greater than an, so we will have an plus I here. And we know we have to sort this in decreasing order, so the smallest element with the first, and we know that ai is definitely smaller than all this remaining element, so ai will come here and a2n will be here, and all the way to an plus 2 will be here, and an plus 1 will be the first element. So now if we see the difference of the absolute difference of the consecutive elements in pq and p dash q dash, it will still be the same, because here we're taking a1 minus an plus 1, here we are still taking an 1 minus a n plus 1, a2 an n plus 2, a2 n plus 2, an a2n, an a2n, and ai an plus I, an plus I, and ai. Simply the positions are different, but the difference is still the same. So it means the partitions p and q and p dash and q dash will still be the same if we just swap two corresponding elements of this partitions. Now we will not swap the corresponding elements, we will swap in general one element which is not we will swap these two elements in general which will not be the corresponding elements, like this. So like for example, in this case our initial partition is this, so we will want to swap, like for example here we will have ai, and here we will have an, here we will have a2n, and here let us take, we will swap here this element which is aj. In general it will be like n plus j for the corresponding aj here, and here it will be an plus I, n plus I, and here it will be an plus 2, and here it will be an plus 1, n plus 1. So let us call these partitions to be p double dash and q double dash. We will compare it with the original partition, which is p and q, which is this partition. So now if we swap ai in general, not with an plus I but with an plus j, if we swap these two elements, so then we need to understand this, that up to this part, the part before that, the corresponding elements will not move at all, so the difference will still be the same. After that, the after aj, the both the parts will move by one, so the difference will still be same. Here the differences will still be same, so this part and this part is unaffected. What about this part? So what will happen, that we will take the difference of ai and an plus j, and then this second term will get difference with the first term here, third term with the second term here. In a similar way, all these differences will be taken. So what we can understand from here is this: even if I move an plus j to here, even I move this part, this thing here and this thing here, right, because we have to take the absolute difference, so we can still assume that these terms are still at their same positions, right? So these terms are still at the same position, but we are taking the difference not with the corresponding elements, but with the elements like diagonally, ai and an plus j, and after that second to the first here, and then third to second here, then fourth, third here, like that. So if we see, we have, because these elements are smaller elements and these elements are bigger elements, So we can, when we take the absolute sum, so that it is obvious from here that the difference will still be the same. The difference will still be the sum of these elements minus the sum of these elements, and plus the sum of these elements plus sum of these elements minus the sum of this element and sum of this element. So it's clear that the sum will not be changing at all if we partition in general the array into p dash and q dash, p double dash and q dash, in such a way that the elements which we are swapping are not corresponding but somewhat like diagonally to each other. So in this way we have proved that CPQ, the cost of partition, will be constant all the time, and the total cost will be the cost of the cost of one partition, that is the sum per partition into the number of partitions, and this number of partition is given by the combinatorics formula. And yeah, that's it. So with this note I will terminate now.